Reserve time.
Possible, yeah, possible, and
10
leave
seconds
a shaker
remaining.
against the Magnus, which I
How's
think.
that matchup then?
Five
Not bad.
seconds
remaining.
It should
So,
favor shaker, right?
I think it's favorite shaker, yeah.
But Magnus can get the. Wow, that is greedy.
Yep. I like that Puppy went for the cult feed level one. Normally you see like a chilling touch, harass, but he knows there is good kill potential, and getting level two can sometimes be a bit slow for a support. Not to mention Yapzor has some rotation potential as well. Then you're looking at three stuns, almost a full 6 seconds of lockdown. Top though, Jerax coming in with a snowball. Bye bye,
Pretty
Kezu.
Big dive on Mr. Kezu and OG. Very healthy. They'll take some tower shots, but.
Jerax at the tower, and then he denied it off of the fly.
Meanwhile, bottom lane, S4 also in trouble. He goes for the Fissure. Stormbolt, though, will find him. They do stack the stun slightly with the cold feet coming through, but the body blocks are on point and Secret strike back. So. Man, so far OG just the lane's going much smoother, not being pressured on no-tail. He's getting his early farm as Kezu is going to get rolled on here up towards the top side. Lucen Beam coming through is holding onto the skewer now, trying to wait out those shards, and he is going to skewer Jerax away to the low ground. But now the shards come through, and you'll catch the tail end of it as Kezu is finished off. Jerax about to be scouted though. It's Yapzor to the rescue. Gonna find him. Do they still make the move? They're gonna snowball in anyway. Ooh, that hail bomb really packs a punch. The stun's there from Yap. It's not enough. He has to carapace and retreat. And now Ana's on the chase. Lobs out the dragon tail, but OG unable to continue pursuit a bit.
Looking to get that as he comes back to lane. And oh god, S4.
This cold feet combination. S4
gets away this
lucky
time.
To make it out alive.
Mid lane. Oh, he didn't get 6 hit on the storm.
Mid one getting ganged up upon, and Yapzor can't do much about it. He does take the dazzle with him, but didn't even get the experience as he dropped first.
With not much kill potential, so the end result is very good.
Secret actually do want to contest. They're coming in. I don't think OG will expect this, though. They might just from the lack of heroes visible on the map right now.
There's a haste rune on Ana, though.
Haste rune on Ana. He probably makes it out S4 with a good Fissure, perhaps, but the cold feed chain stun could be enough. Fissure is there. Ana able to just sneak out for the cold feed. The stun in the trees actually finds it, but Yapzor doesn't have the follow up that he wanted. And now it's OG's turn to chase the other way. Ana comes in just as the haste rune, or sorry, just as the dragon form ends, he gets off the dragon tail, and now Yapzor going for the TP out with the carapace. Heal bomb. No, S4 slams the door, gets the stun, gets the kill in secret, not only going for the smoke, but having it backfire in their faces. Cleaning
Man,
up the entrance. Then certainly excelling at those creep stack takedowns, but secret group up again behind Ana, behind the Dragonite. Now they've popped down a sentry, they're gonna find Yapzor, this pest from game number one. However, still proving to be a pestilence here in game number two. They commit on him. They're not able to do much, and the dragon absolutely goes splat. OG, losing a core piece of their push, will be denied in their efforts here. It's Ana, who gets scouted out initially, mid one. We'll see him, but coming in from the side is S4, and he's going to find his old friend, his old Capitan, down in the river. But backup comes in. They've got the tower still online. The Ice Blast is there, and again, they will strike, taking down Ana, but the trade is S4! Slams them down! Oh, that Shaker packing a punch! The level 4 Aftershock, don't sleep on it. Now the Fissure from distance isolates Puppy, and from the side, Secret looking to clean up Jerax, who was coming in for the assist. He's low, not dead just yet. Will they have the shockwave damage? It's level 3. The grave comes out pretty early. MP. Oh, the shard pushing himself somehow down to the low ground. Gets him out to safety. And it could make this next fight more difficult. Very close to the completed blink now as the jump is onto No-Tail. Ice Blast again. It's perfectly placed by Puppy. Locking down No-Tail. They kill him off quickly. And now S4 trapped in the trees. This might delay the blink. Isolated boy, he would sure love the Echo Slam now. But sadly, that has a cooldown. Secret strike back. Two cores for them. All three have died for OG in the last minute, minute and a half or so.
This insta first two AA pick just completely ruins the dazzle and combos so well with Secret's draft. And yeah, they immediately smoke up.
Yapzor's in front, has the Vendetta. Remember though, OG have been very diligent about Sentry. So if he just tries to walk in to start the fight, they might have their surprise unveiled a bit prematurely. Carapace quickly as he runs up the cliff. Nothing scouted, but an important kill to be gained. It's Ana who gets balled on again, pulled back into the Ice Blast. See you later, Ana. Secret just...
S4's found a fortunate Invis rune, and this could actually get them a big kill, though.
Mid one. No, they hesitate!
Oh, no.
And he balls away.
Yep, that slight hesitation. It's so awkward going for that gank around the trees because... You think you have it, then he goes into fog for a second just because... Oh, Blink Echo, they still want it.
S4 sees he's out of mana. He's going to commit for
this
and mid one
it.
Down anyway at the tower.
You take that.
If there was a hero behind him, S4 may have just Anna, not another death for him into the Ice Blast pile driven by the Magnus. Oh, goodness gracious. He cannot keep dying. Way on top when it comes to net worth. Actually, no, not as far as I thought. Only at 1,000 gold, but still a decent margin considering he's not gone for like a pure farming build.
OG trying to bait this mid tier one. Secret not taking it, even though they see Shaker bottom.
Here, who's going to get the jump here? It's Yapzor in front, walks right into a sentry. OG lurking back, and now the Ballers punch to start things off. They commit a lot on Yapzor, but falling in from afar is mid one. The Ice Blast is there again. Jump the Dragonite, hit him with the Ice Blast, shut him down. That's the call for Secret, and it seems to be working so far. The Echo Slam from S4, decent, but not enough because MP has the BKB just slashing away. What's the Sigil 2? Can't quite finish it though, but they get the kill again. The Dragonite down, the Echo Slam committed. They lost their Storm, but now they can turn on the towers, and OG, lacking firepower, have to back away. Even in the middle of that fight, No-Tail forced to commit. It does feel like it could have been very different. You take away some of those pickoffs and the deaths on Ana, especially when they were trying to push top, and that tower's probably down. It's a very different game, but instead it's Secret just finding the openings. Ana TP's in again, this time into the RP. Again, the Ice Blast there. Grave ain't gonna save you, my friend, and neither will it No-Tail as the game collapses. OG are reeling punch after punch, blow after blow from Puppy and Friends. Oh, getting eclipsed. Sven is atop him. Magnus has also grabbed a Midas. Secret having more and more access into late game as again, Yapzor starts the party, finds Fly early. Gonna deal with the Sigil. Nah, he says I'll take the hero kill instead. And it's just like a highlight reel of...
I think that's Fly like, all right, my DK needs an item. Go farm where it's safe. I'm gonna go create some space for you, but... Yapzor is finding pick after pick.
More and more. S4, you can't afford this death, my friend. Up to the high ground he goes. Kezu there cuts him off. Drills him with a well-placed shockwave and finds the kill. Puppy has been caged up. He's got the BKB. BKB TP out. Don't know that there's a whole lot to do with. There is a Walrus Punch. He's going to turn. Try to fight the Walrus Punch. Now commit. MP standing his ground. He's low, though. Has to get out of here soon. The team is coming. Buying time. The shards off the mark. Oh, that could really cost OG. Kezu's in position with the RP, but they have to beware the Eclipse.
The Eclipse.
Ooh.
Just to they get
almost,
the kill,
they
yeah.
almost all walked into it. Secret were like, we could take this fight, but No-Tail could also just get himself an ultra kill.
Sven had blink up as well. So.
Now they want to fight, though. Yapzor's sticking around. Puppy's there. He's got the Ice Blast. What an impale! Sets it up on two. Well done. Well placed. So they have the follow-up. Kezu comes in. Not the best RP, but it's decent at that. That'll net them a second. Fly in the trees. Now no teleport scroll either. Even Ana coming in a bit late. Stuns mid one, but doesn't have the damage. They're going to lock him down for now, trapped in the trees. But of course, he can ball his way out. I don't think they saw Fly's lack of TP. 20 seconds without one. Now, although he has it, waiting on the cooldown, that seems.
No BKBs on either carry make dealing with this item very, very difficult.
Finds his opening, jumps in again. The snowball's there. Decent save opportunity by Jerax. Dodges the Ice Blast. Rolls them into harm's way, though. MP is waiting with that cleaver of his. Gets the stun on No-Tail. Push back, but not quite enough. They pull him in. He does get the grave. He's a bit tankier. Looks like he's likely to drop. What else can they find as a trade in turn? The Echo comes from S4. They need the ball for MP. Kezu skewers him away, saves his friend. MP survives. Now the Warcry back. Jerax cutting him off. Barely at that with the shards, but still it's Ana on the run. The Dragonite scurries back to high ground, impales slightly off the mark. The Fissure cuts them off at the pass. Now S4. And again, mid one's maybe got a little cocky, though the RP is there and he's got the Aegis. Round two, likely to be uglier for OG. They continue pushing their way forward. Mid one, plenty of mana to play around with here. Has to be careful though. Shrine gets tapped. They will down S4, and now they back. A pretty decent trade for that Aegis. Radiant scan might scout this out. OG staying on the other side.
They're trying to bait the rune.
Yapzor. Oh, that's not really the hero you want. He's going to take it, and Ana even blinking in. Time and again, it seems like he's the one getting caught out. Mid one's there with the pull. He gets off the BKB. The Eclipse rains down from above. Does bring the Nyx low, but he gets off the Carapace, locking No-Tail position. He survives for now. He's going to completely withstand this onslaught. Ana isolated on the low ground. Feels like the story of this game. A dragon completely having its wings clip. The Ice Blast there, but a great snowball save by Jerax gives him the breath of fresh life. Is it enough? MP still hanging on, holds the BKB. They've got the RP. They're hanging on. No-Tail out in front. In danger, though. He can't withstand this level of physical damage on his own. He needs the backup. Kezu coming in there with the RP. They don't have to follow up. Perfect Fissure. OG out fighting the crap out of Secret, completely isolating Kezu. They're going to bring him down, too.
Storm's respawning, but they back off. OG, oh my gosh. How do they win that fight?
Outplayed. Oh.
Well,
breath
it's still
of fresh air.
Still a big uphill battle for OG. They are down 14,000 gold against a lineup that is meant to take them in the late game, and they have not itemized for late game. We get to see
another look
at some of these plays.
Three more fights like that. Oh, I don't know if we should be looking at these because Yapzor is hunting no-tail mid. The Luna in danger gets caught out. Stunned for now. MP there chunking him down. No-tail out for 75. And
rather than find yourselves in a spot where you may not break the high ground and miss out on farm, they're just going to play the efficiency game, and they've still got a good 3 minutes to go for another high ground attempt, or at least wait for a fight or a good team pickoff to lead them into the high ground.
They just venture out of their base. They are a bit scouted out here. Gem is not in the neighborhood. That's Jerex packing, and he's all the way over to the right. Ice Blast having a fish off the mark, but Secret still marching up. Yapzor quite confident here. Perhaps a bit too much gets the push down.
Nice force.
And back towards safety. And finally, Honest BKB is complete.
And see Yapzor, very confident mix player. He immediately runs up to the high
speaking
ground.
Of confidence, mid one's got that too. MP jumps in, BKB deletes the Dragonite. Story of this game. Getting picked off at crucial moments. Ana has had a rough go of it, and now mid one, leaping further, going deeper. Kezu's there. Nice RP. The follow-up comes through. Your Eclipse does nothing. No tail, they say. One swing of that sword nearly finishes him off. Aegis does get popped. MP keeps a cleaving through. And last desperation times now emerge for OG. No Eclipse. No Echo. No Dragon Knight. They'll triple buyback to hold the line, but the gold loss is catastrophic.
Yeah, it's one of those fights where
it's not really a crucial match for them. It's the LGD match, as you mentioned, Gods, that will decide their fate, but this certainly gives them confidence going in and more confidence for mid one as he jumps forward, but a good snowball save. Doesn't seem to matter though. Ana tried to limp away, and that means mid one will pounce. Forces him back, isolating Jerex, now taking the Tusk out of the picture. No tail, standing his ground for now. Sven arrives. Has that God Strength ready to go. He's hitting for almost 700 damage of Swain. Doesn't even need to activate the Satanic just yet. Stun is there. Chewing rapidly through the Luna, forcing out the BKB. Yap adds a bit of assistance, but only tickles the Luna in comparison. That is almost the max weave.
Just because of where OG are stuck in their base.
But OG have the high ground. I'm not going to need to avoid pulling out as Anakin Skywalker if he wants to take this fight. Here comes the ball, and mid one goes right for Fly to start the fight, gets off the BKB, silencing him, not following up with damage output, but Yapzor is there with the stun, connects for the kill. MP, meanwhile, looking to hit really anyone. Kezu's with the RP, but he pushes him away. Might open up an opportunity here. S4 getting the echo off the Eclipse, rains down, and it only tickles. Nothing in the end. No damage for OG. The road ends here, eliminated first from Manila, and now Gods from Epicenter. Whew. Your Kiev major champions looking a little mortal.
And that's one of the funny things with OG. They have won more Valp